So share with us your insight on this painting by Henri Matisse.
So this one really excites me a lot, and I'll share why. First of all, I've been trying to buy it for 14 years. 14 years ago, it was in a museum exhibition. I saw it, and I met the people that owned it, who happened to be direct descendants of Henri Matisse. And they were telling me about it, how this had never, ever been on the market. It stayed in the family. Yet it had been in, I'm trying to say this, 14 different museum exhibitions. Pretty darn good. And it was in, pictured in 13 different books. That's rather amazing. Matisse loved this painting. So every really very famous person had that moment that they changed from semi-famous to famous, or from famous to super famous. And I would also put that the artist Matisse in the top 10 artists of all time in Western art. So what changed Matisse from being really famous to being like a superstar? And that was in 1951, MoMA, Museum of Modern Art, did a retrospective of his work. And here's a picture of the retrospective. This was a year before Matisse died, and they asked Matisse to pick out his favorite works. And you can see our painting in MoMA at this exhibition. So Matisse picked this out as one of his most favorite paintings. So let's talk about it a little bit. Well, I think we'll go to the next slide, so we'll get a little bit better of a picture of it. Well, first of all, here's the exhibition catalog from the MoMA in 1951, showing the Matisse. And let's go to our picture of the painting next. So why is this so important? This was painted in 1918 when Matisse was escaping the northern France, where World War I was still raging on, and went to southern France, went to Nice. He painted with Renoir. Renoir was painting the same scenes, and Renoir got really mad at him because he said, "I don't understand how you, at such a young man, understand light so much better than I do, and I've been painting for 70 years. And so he paints this is a village in Nice, and the road going up, and it's just big, and it's peaceful, and it's wonderful. So here's a painting that's never left the family besides it to go to the museums. Matisse picked it out himself for a retrospective that turned him into the superstar. It's been in 14 different international exhibitions and pictured in 13 different books. It just doesn't get any better than that. And then I'll show you other examples in museums. Here's one of Nice, the exact same period, nowhere near as pretty as ours in MoMA, in Museum of Modern Art. Here's one in the Tate, nowhere near as pretty, a little bit earlier than ours. Here's one the exact same period in the Met. I think it's different than ours. I like it a lot. I prefer ours, but I still like that one a lot. Here's one in the Met from the exact same period, a little bit different, a lot different of a feel, but the same period when he was in Nice. So we have all these examples. Let me show you the size of the painting. You can see the scale of the painting here. It just has wonderful scale. It's beautiful. It's about, if you made a list of all the Matisse works, it's unequivocally in the top 5% large in size. So it has scale. You feel like you're there. So it's, to me, it's the best of all worlds. It's a completely private Matisse that had never been on the market, descended through his family's many examples in many museums. And this one itself has been in 14 different museums. It just doesn't really get any better than that.
Yeah, it's a fantastic piece. Definitely wall presence, if you see it here in the gallery and as displayed on here. One of the questions was, besides Renoir, who else influenced Matisse? So I guess from that quote that you mentioned of Renoir, they're wondering who else might have influenced Matisse at this time or throughout his life.
So I mentioned Van Gogh was probably the first artist to change, to move from the realistic paintings that were done in the academic, where everything was realistic, to a little bit less realistic, you know, just a little bit off. The two that came after me that really changed were Cézanne and Matisse. Matisse was heavily influenced by Cézanne. He was influenced by Gauguin, and he was influenced by Van Gogh. These were the three artists that Matisse loved more than anybody else. He loved Renoir too, of course, although Renoir didn't love him. So it's really, you know, it's art with a capital A.